Coach's Corner.
Drop it, Tom. Got Murray's in there.
All right, we can't take the whole thing.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. It's almost over.
All right. I don't think it's
I worked
over.
Hard on that. Look at the... Anyhow,
you
stop
love
it,
Tom.
Tom.
We all love Tom. Yeah. Yeah. Grand finale. You want to show the clip from 20 years ago?
Go ahead. You got lots of hair, too.
Yeah.
You must get a real kick out of how this is. I mean, started in Ottawa, I think, Tom, but you tell me, where did the hockey song become the legend it did this year?
Well, this year, I guess it was, Senators started the ball rolling. The Leafs picked it up. And as near as I can figure out, it's been all across now in every franchise, and I'm the happiest guy in the world. I'm, you know, sitting in a nice chair. I never thought I'd be here talking to you and saying hello and all that. I'm not going to give as hard a time as Grapes does, but, you know.
Nobody can, thank heavens.
Hockey in Canada is our natural and national sport, our national pastime. When I was a little kid, when there was six teams and all that, I mean, hockey is Canada.
One last question. I saw you were in New Brunswick to receive a degree. There's another difference between you and Don Cherry.
I like that. He's going to catch me. He's outside. Yeah. He's going to get me for this one.
He's got all your records. He said, I got all the records and three tapes. I've got them all on none CD so far.
He's going to get me.
He always thanked you for the royalties, by the way, for the hockey song. And you got him two beers that day, remember?
Yeah, I got him two beers, boy.
Okay, Larry Walker. Here's what he had to say about the riot today between Team Canada and Mexico. He said, hey, it's Saturday night. We're just trying to get on hockey night in Canada. Don Cherry can't wait to show these highlights.
Now, watch. So he tries three times to hit him, and they're mad. Mexicans are mad because we bunted up score. He gets him the third time. Gormley, the umpire, he's 40 years, I think he's been in it. He hits him here. Tony Toronto boy, he's not going to take that. Don't you take that. The catcher, yeah, the catcher goes. Watch, we really throw them here at the end.
Why'd we run up the score?
Well, you got to run up the score in the tournament. And they said before the tournament, some baseball guys, we don't do that. And look at the lefties going there. You don't run up a score. But we had to run up the score because that's what they do in a tournament. And this is what we did. Watch this guy hit him and run. But he gets him down. Watch a good guy. Boom! A left-hander, he gets him down. It's a way to go like that. Good Canadian points. We got to beat the Americans tomorrow.
So that brings us, Larry just about got dumped on right there.
Yeah,
it brings us to, obviously, Drazinski gets hurt in the fight with Fraser McLaren of Toronto. So I think everybody has seen it. We're not going to show it.
No,
Fraser was asked what caused it. He said our team had been flat starting games. So I said to David, do you want to go? And he said no. But then when the puck
let
was,
me just say that. Good, yeah. You know what I think of Fraser. I mean, I love the guy. But here's the way you do it. You don't, when you're a super heavyweight like him, this kid is just up from the American Hockey League. He's had nine games. He's got two goals, by the way. Davey's got two goals. He shot when he said no. He wants to feel his way a little. And McLaren should never have done that. I'm telling him right now, I love the guy. But you don't do that. Probert wouldn't do it. And Davey, all I got to say to you, Probert, when he first started, I saw him get knocked out cold by Todd Ewing. They had to lift him up and carry him. Don't you quit. You got to get right back on again. But
it's a complicated thing, Don, because Fraser, obviously, if he starts a fight, he's an instigator, 2-5.
No,
possibly.
You can't. Look, you don't do that if right. You're a super heavyweight.
So should the league suspend or fine
Fraser for admitting to staging? Stop that staging stuff. Yeah, I'm just telling you, the code is when you're good like that, you're super heavyweight, you don't get a kid like that till the kid's a rookie, actually. Anyhow, let's go on. And, you know, we talk about fighting. I read about it. Leafs are tough, not the fighting. They're tough because of the fighting. Let's go over again who does not like the fighting. First of all, the media does not like the fighting, you know.
Because they have a responsibility.
Yeah, they have a response. They get in free, and half of them wouldn't even be there if they could. The good meal and the whole deal. Who likes fighting? First of all, the players like fighting. The fan. Let's see the fans or the player. Let's see one or the other. Watch this here goal. They're the guys. Watch this. This is Erskine going. And Scott Thornton, a real good guy. Now, this is here. Kingston boy, by the way, Erskine. Now, watch him tap him at the end. Now, see the players? They love it. The fans love it. The whole deal. These are the people.
But nobody likes to see the guy get hurt.
Nobody likes to see a guy like. But you know what? I always say, I'm getting the visors later. I admire a guy like Kiprios that he got KO'd and he stands up for it. Fighting's in the game. Fighting should be in the game. The only people are only timid souls,
you know,
like the media.
When and look, I'm with you on fighting. So but I'm just being devil's advocate.
Oh, you're going to say it's stage fighting. Either you like it or you don't like it. Don't give me that stage
I'm saying get rid of the instigator rule because otherwise.
Oh, hey, I've been trying to get rid of it now for 20 years. That's
the only way you
did it.
Yeah. Okay.
And the players voted 95% to take the year right.
Because these guys are time bombs on the. We got a minute left.
A minute.
Okay. Well, we're right out of time.
I'm sorry, folks.
One last thing, though. The visor and same with fighting.
I'm going to get into the visor and everything like
next
that.
Time.
I don't have time right now. I've got to do a great policeman. I don't know why I don't get more time. I'm serious about this. This is ridiculous. I don't get more time. Anyhow, we got a beautiful Steve Drury policeman, and you can see he was killed. He went to a domestic quarrel. And God love him, he's 25 years old. In Ottawa, they had a funeral of 1,000 guys. Celine, his mom, we send condolences. His dad, Gilles, he's got two brothers. Matt, Ben's a fireman. And you believe it or not, his dad is a Royal Canadian Military Police guy. His other wounded partner who went there is Josh Borland. He's only 25. And I tell you, boy, these guys go out in the morning. They don't know if they're coming back. They're the best, I'll tell you. God love you.
Coach's Corner on CBC. Brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights. Buy yours now at Budweiser.ca.